Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Excel bootcamp course that you can find on my website at bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, in this video, we're gonna take this very boring, plain old Excel spreadsheet and turn it into this page-sized boring Excel spreadsheet. Okay, just so that we can be using actual letter, US letter sizes or A4 sizes, we'll look at changing the measurements, okay, the default inches to millimeters as well, getting ready to build our quote in this tutorial series. So let's go and do that now. Okay, so first up, let's create this first option here. It says blank workbook. Okay, and we get our kind of standard Excel layout. Now we want to change this to be more of a page layout because we're going to be printing this, making PDFs, emailing it, that type of thing. So what we need to do is go along the top here to view and switch along to this third option here called page layout. Okay, you can toggle back to normal if you prefer, but page layout is going to allow us to kind of, yeah, get our page size so there's no point using the cells that are over here because they're not going to be able to print on one sheet. The other thing to double check when we get started is the size of our page and maybe these margins from the edges here. So I'm based in Europe, so I'm going to use A4 or letter. I'll use letter because most of you, my students, are based in the US. But let's go along to page layout. And along here it says size. Okay, we can switch this from A4, which is the default here for me in Ireland, over to US letter. Okay. The other thing we might do is I've got mine set to inches. You might be setting yours to metric. Okay, you might want centimeters and millimeters. You do that over on file, down to options. Where are you there? Then you go to advanced options. Okay, and somewhere along here, scroll. There it is, ruler units. Okay, yours might be set to default, so it'll pick which country you're in, but say I do stuff for the US all the time and for Europe, so I have to switch between these two. You might switch it to centimeters or millimeters. Okay, I'm gonna force mine on inches. Let's click okay. Next thing I wanna do is, still under page layout, we're gonna go to margins, and I'm just gonna make them a little bigger. I'm gonna go to wide, and it just puts the edges away from, yeah, bit of the space margins between the edges of the page. Just looks better. We don't have a lot of detail in a quote, so we can kind of center in the page a little bit more. Great, so that's how to set up your page sizes, change the measurements, get your margins right. Now we're gonna go in the next video and look at adding images to our quote. Hey, did you enjoy it? If you did, please click subscribe or like, click the little alert bell as well. All of these things really help me as a business. Also, if you want the full course, check out the Excel Bootcamp on bringyourownlaptop.com. There's that course plus many others. All right, bye now.